Okay, so just to update the film, around about a year ago, I was using this bike for work. I was riding the bike to work and back, and it seemed to be going well. However, it developed a sort of a misfire and backfire. And so then, while trying to fix it, I got a new CDI box. That's the CDI box. It just it's located here on the left hand side, just behind a small cover. I got an alternative one, so I purchased this one to find out whether or not the problem was the CDI box. Once I installed that and pushed the starter button, it seemed to cause damage, and from then on, when this threw out, it only makes a sort of a knocking noise, and it won't turn the engine. I took the old starter motor off, which is that one there, and put a new one on, and it didn't fix the problem. It's not the starter button, I've bypassed that, and it made no difference. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a test that I've got rigged up with this, the old starter motor here. And so I'll cut straight to the chase. When you take this, the back cover off, and that's the cover there, you expose that, and when you've got it connected to a battery, you push it in, and that's what gets the throw out and gets your starter motor turning. So in other words, when you push the starter motor button to start the motor, that one there, current from the battery, there's a lead connected there, and that activates this throwout, and that pushes in and starts the starter motor turning and your engine turning. What I'm going to do now is just find out whether or not there's a short in the wiring between the battery that goes to the starter button and back to the starter. I'm going to see if there's a short in it. I'm going to do this same test on the bike. So for that test, I had a positive going to the positive terminal on the starter and a negative to a ground on the starter. There's a direct starter button you can get on eBay, and so you've got this cap here, and it's got a button sticking out that you can push in and activate it by hand and start the motor that way. So I might have to buy one of them. Okay, so I'm on the other side of the bike now, and that's the starter motor there. That's the cap I have to get off, and that would be the button to activate the starter motor. Okay, on the other side of the bike now, the starter motor and the solenoid. The solenoid's connected to the starter motor, and to undo it, I just undo these two bolts here, one there and one there. So I'll just I'll get the starter motor off, undo the starter button cover on the other side, or the push activation part of the starter motor, and when that's pushed, this throws out connects with the clutch hub gear here that turns and rotates the motor. Okay, success. I've found the problem. The problem is a short somewhere between the battery, the wire that goes up to the starter button, and the wire that goes back to the throwout switch on the starter. So you can see there that the back of the new starter is exposed, and it's connected up to the cables from the battery, making sure that none of the wires touch the engine, and that the wires, the positive is connected to the positive and the negative is connected to the negative. It's much easier than you think to get them mixed up. And for the first time in about 6 to 8 months, you'll see that the throwout cog, which is just there, will be activated up against the cog of the clutch basket, and the engine will turn. Believe me, there's no truer saying than if you can't kick it, it's not worth owning. When I push the starter motor activator in, it seems to sort of jam on something. It's almost as if, you know, the engine's seized, or these leads here could be burnt out. It's strange, because it was working okay. I don't think the engine's seized. So that was a fully charged battery, and the clicking noise is gone, but now it won't rotate the engine. What I'll do now is demonstrate that the engine's not seized. Compression, but the engine is not seized. Got a bit of a compression tight spot, but apart from that, it's can hear the air going past the rings there. I'll turn the key onto the on position and see if it makes any difference. Okay, well, what I'll do next is I'll replace these cables. That would explain everything if the cables were, you know, burnt out or just old and worn, or had a bad connection. That'd explain the backfiring and poor performance with the motor, and it'd also explain the starter motor not working. If you have a look at any of the previous videos, you'll see that I bypassed these and I connected the car cable up with the starter motor and the ground. That, together with the push-in hand-activated throwout. There's really nothing more to test other than replacing these leads. They're about the same thickness as these, and I did bypass these on a couple of tests and put the jumper leads straight onto the positive and the negative from a battery of the starter motor. So I've bypassed the cables and it still had the same effect or the same problem. I don't believe it's these cables, but they're really the only thing left to replace. There's really no other test. You've got your starter motor, you've got the positive and the negative, and the hand activated throwout, which simply draws current through the starter motor, and it's a self-containing assembly with pushing in the back. It takes the switch out of the equation, and so I replace these, and if that's not the problem, I'll be a monkey's uncle.